Welcome to This Cultural Life, the series in which the world's leading creative people reveal the formative influences and experiences that inspired their own work. I'm John Wilson, and my guest in this episode is the award-winning choreographer, Sir Matthew Bourne. A latecomer to professional dance, he shook up classical ballet with his groundbreaking company, Adventures in Motion Pictures, first with a radical new version of the Nutcracker, and then, in 1995, with an all-male Swan Lake. Since then, he's continued to popularise classical dance with a succession of innovative productions, often drawing inspiration from movies or literature. He's had hits with The Red Shoes, Edward Scissorhands, Dorian Gray and The Lord of the Flies, and has won Olivier and Tony Awards. Matthew Bourne was knighted in 2016 for services to dance. Sir Matthew Bourne, welcome to This Cultural Life.
Thank you. Very good to be here.
You are arguably one of the world's most successful living choreographers. How would you describe the work you do?
I don't know. It's always been a problem with me, the labels of what to call what I do, you know, and it's got a bit easier now because people sort of understand. I used to get a lot of, oh, he's not really a choreographer, he's more of a director and all this kind of thing. And I even questioned it myself after a while. But I am a choreographer, you know, I make up steps. It's a story told through dance. My parents had a great love of Hollywood musicals and MGM musicals, and they would build these things up, make them exciting for me before I'd even seen them. In those days, of course, you had to watch it when it was on. You couldn't record it or anything. So they'd build it. It's on Saturday afternoon, you know, we're going to watch Singing in the Rain or The Bandwagon or something for the first time. And, you know, I absolutely adored these things.
So the Hollywood musicals were important from a young age. Yes. And the first big moment you've chosen for This Cultural Life, a formative influence, is Seeing the Sound of Music.
Yes.
Was that at home on television, or would that have been in the cinema?
No, I chose it because it led to this great love of musicals, musical theatre, but it was probably the first one I was taken to see at the Dominion Tottenham Court Road, where I found out fairly recently that it played for 5 years. It's unbelievable to know that now, you know, that a film played for 5 years in one venue. So I think I saw it when I was about 5 or 6, and I loved going into this enormous cinema with this enormous screen and that beginning of that film where you go over the hills and you end up in Salzburg and Julie Andrews on the hill coming across. You know, it's still, for me, the most exciting opening to any film. I think the influence of that as a small kid, and it was overwhelming. I think life-changing, really. The hills fill my heart
with the sound of music. Isn't it interesting? Because it is, I mean, I described it as a theatre. You're talking about it as a cinema. Mm. It's a venue where I think you played later, didn't you? I mean, that was one of the venues in which you staged Swan Lake.
Yes, we did, yeah. It's a very significant venue for me. But of course, it was the beginning of seeing a lot of those big blockbuster musicals in particular on the big screen. They were re-releasing films like West Side Story and Seven Brides for Seven Brothers quite regularly at cinemas in those days. And the dancing in those films really excited me. And I wanted to recreate them once I'd seen them. And I did put on my own little shows at that point where I kind of copied and did things from memory and made up. I wouldn't have known the word choreography in those days, but I put a show together.
So you're talking about Hollywood musicals there featuring choreography and dance, and yet Sound of Music, despite the spectacle, the drama, the singing, there's not a lot of choreographed movement in that film.
No, there isn't. It's interesting that I made that choice. It's partly because it was the beginning of probably me loving going to the cinema, but also such a brilliantly made film. It's easy to be funny about The Sound of Music and it's saccharine, but actually it's a brilliantly made film by Robert Wise, who also did West Side Story, another absolutely masterpiece movie that I love so much. And as well as falling in love with musicals, I think I fell in love with cinema as well. It told its story so brilliantly, and the use of location was so exciting. And the reason I chose it is because it was the start of something, I think.
Was it the story? You know, when you take yourself back, young Matthew sitting there, you know, what is the overriding impact of that film on your imagination?
If I try and think about it now, I love the music, and I've always loved Rodgers and Hammerstein ever since. But I kind of fell in love with Julie Andrews.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favourite things.
I used to kiss a picture of her before I went to bed on the back of the album cover.
Every night?
I did, for a while, when I was very young. I thought, I don't know why. It's interesting, my mum looked a bit like Julie Andrews, actually. But, you know, it wasn't that I needed another mother. I had a very good mother. I don't know.
Were you in love with her, do you think?
I think I was, you know, and to a certain extent, I still am. I love her.
When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favourite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
I don't know. Even if the movie starts on the TV today and I catch the beginning of it, that's it. That's me gone for 2.5-3 hours. You know, I can't stop watching it. It's just magic to me.
Have you ever met Julie Andrews?
Yes.
Did you get a chance to tell her about your
album
kissing moment?
Well, my friend Cameron McIntosh, who I'm working with at the moment on Old Friends, the musical I'm working on, he did something wonderful for me when Swan Lake opened on Broadway, which was a thrill enough as it was. He secretly invited Julie to the opening, and I was very nervous on that night, obviously. And when she got out of the car, I wasn't expecting her to be there. I didn't care about anything else. It just made everything all right. Spoonful of sugar. It was just sort of this has made my life, you know. This has certainly made my night anyway.
So seeing Julie Andrews in The Sound of Music at the age of 5, that sowed the seeds of your love of the musicals.
Yes.
What was happening at school at this time, creatively?
Well, I hated school mostly.